हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, आय एम मिस्टर पी पी मित्रगोत्री, असोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेकॅनिकल इंजिनिअरिंग ॲट वालचंद इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नॉलॉजी, सोलापूर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग टाईप्स ऑफ प्रेस वर्किंग डाईज. नाऊ लर्निंग आउटकम फॉर धिस पर्टिक्युलर सेशन is students will be able to select a proper press tool for manufacture of sheet metal component at least possible cost. Now, before understanding what are press working dies, first of all, let us understand what is a press working and what is its significance. Now, press working is a chipless manufacturing process by which various components are made from sheet metals. It involves working of a sheet between two dies. In press working, the upper die is called a punch and the process is termed as cold stamping. Now, before going to the next slide, I want to tell you the significance of press working. Now, this press working with sheet metal is very significant as far as automotive industry is considered. Friends, you may not imagine there are more than 200 press components which are used in a car, and there are more than 40 to 50 components made by press working which are used in two wheelers and three wheelers. So you will find press working as essential part of automotive industry. It is essential need of automotive industry. Now next we will study what are the press working dies. Before that we will study what is die. The die is defined as the female part of a complete press tool for producing the work in a press. It is also referred to a complete tool consists of pair of mating members for producing work in a press. Now, classification of dies is the next portion. In that, we can classify the dies in two ways, depending upon according to the type of press operation, that is cutting dies and forming dies. Cutting dies are the dies which are used for cutting operations. Cutting operation means piercing a hole, cutting a blank, slitting, lensing. These are some of the cutting operations which are carried out with cutting dies. Forming dies are used to carry out stretch forming, cup drawing, and some other related. Bending dies are also referred as forming dies. Second way of classifying the dies is according to the method of operation. Now, these can be classified into seven different ways, that is simple dies or single operation die, compound dies, combination dies, gang dies, gang and follow dies, progressive dies, and transfer dies. Now, in the next slide, we will discuss every type of die set, its application, its limitations. Now, simple dies or single operation dies are as shown in the sketch. These are single action dies. They produce one component per stroke. These single operation dies or simple dies can perform cutting operation or may be employed for forming operation. Simple dies require a press operator to load and unload the component, that is, loading and unloading of the component in case of simple dies is manually done, and part material is to be manually placed, and after each press cycle, part material is to be withdrawn. It means that the time required for production of the component on simple dies is much greater. Time consumed for particular operation is greater. And single operation die or simple dies are generally used only when blanking or piercing operation is to be done, or only some bending operation or something is to be done, and these dyes are used for simple shapes. Now some simple shapes which are formed by use of simple dyes are shown in this slide. You can observe various contoured parts can be produced with the help of simple dyes. Now, if you have a component to be manufactured as shown in the sketch, in the slide, that is parts produced by compound dye, you can find that it involves two operations. Every component involves two operations, blanking and piercing. And these two operations can be performed with simple dyes by using two simple or single cutting dyes. But instead of that, if you want to perform both the operations simultaneously, instead of simple dyes, you can go for compound dyes. In compound dyes, you can observe that two or more operations may be performed at one station. It is specifically employed for cutting operation only. And as both the operations are taking place in single setting, accuracy and concentricity maintained and tolerances maintained will be better, and production of component will be definitely economical and fast as compared to using two simple dyes. But compound dyes, no doubt, initial cost are high and they are complex in nature. Now, next type of dye where we can perform two or more operations is combination dyes. But combination dyes differ from compound dyes in a way that in compound dyes you can perform both cutting operations, but in combination dyes, one cutting operation and another forming operation, if it is to be carried out, you can go for combination dyes. It differs from compound dyes in that respect. And in this case, presses required are double acting, while in case of compound dyes, single acting press can be employed. While during forming operation, the first blank which is cut and then blanking punch acts as a punch holder. And this is very costly, and the blank cut and shell drawn is shown. Blank is cut in the first operation and shell is drawn in the second operation. Now, next type of dye is gang dyes. Now, you look to the component shown at the bottom in the sketch. You find that there are more than two or three piercing operations in a blank, rectangular blank. If you want to perform this at one stroke, you have to go for gang dyes. Gang dye is nothing but a single operation dye, or you can say that modification of a simple dye. Only thing is that to the punch head, we will have to mount more than one punches, and dye block will have more than one dye cavity. And gang dye will look as shown in the sketch. It is employed for cutting operation only. Now all the punches are operating simultaneously in gang dyes, as a result of which force requirements are normally very high. That is the trouble. Now I will pose one question before you, that is how we can reduce the force requirements in case of gang dyes. You think over it and you try to find out the answer for that. Now, one solution I will give for that is gang and follow dyes. Gang and follow dyes is nothing but modification of a gang dyes. Only thing is that number of punches, in case of gang and follow dyes also, number of punches are mounted, but all punches are staggered, as a result of which every punch will operate after first punch has completed its operation, second punch will start operating, and after second punch operates, operation is complete, third punch will begin its operation, and last punch will begin its operation after third punch finishes its operation, as a result of which force requirements are considerably reduced as compared to the gang dyes. Now, four most important dyes which are used for mass production is progressive dyes. The name itself suggests that progressive dyes are multispectration dyes. It performs number of operations at two or more stations during each stroke. It can perform very complex work. It is used for large run of production. Both coiled and strip stock can be used for it. Stock is automatically located during the operation, so accuracy of operation is very good. And generally, single pass layout is preferred. And progressive die is as shown in the sketch. Now, last die is transfer dies. These are also multi-station dies, but they differ from progressive dies is that already cut blank is transferred mechanically from one station to other station in multi-station dies, and several dies are mounted in case of transfer die set in line or in a circle. Now, at the end of this session, we will study comparison between progressive dies and transfer dies. No doubt, both are multi-station operation dies, but progressive die uses continuous strip or stock, while previously cut blank is fed to the transfer dies. Progressive dies can be run at higher speeds with shorter press strokes, and scrap loss is completely low in case of transfer dies, but transfer mechanism has higher initial cost in case of transfer dies. Now, at the end of this session, I will ask you to refer a textbook of production engineering by P.C. Sharma, tool design by Donaldson, press tool design by IGTR Aurangabad. Thank you.